Hi, this is Brett, and I'm here with Chris Wright from Freedom Tracks. Chris, talk to me a little bit about this apparatus. You guys have been around for 5 years, and how do you market this thing? As a marketing guy, what's your goal to market the Freedom Tracks?
The main thing on marketing it is we want it to look cool. We want it to be, you know, something that everybody looks like, I really want to do that. So, and we want to be able to get people back out to places they normally can't go, in the sand, in the snow, and that type of thing. So we're really trying to just get as many people in it as possible. Because once you get in it, it's a blast.
Yeah, I can, and that's not just marketing speak. You know, once you do get in it, it does. I mean, it's true to its name, right? It's freedom. You know, we were down a moment ago at you know, it's a pretty interesting terrain, and I'm not afraid to admit on the record that I was quite scared, but I've never been in something like this before. As you shared with us before we started filming, you know, you can hop out at any point when things start going south. But talk to me about the importance of weight distribution and what makes this thing, you know, be able to handle gradients and rocks and all kinds of stuff, because I thought that was pretty interesting when we were talking about that.
Okay, so basically you're looking at a track here that's roughly a little bit over 2 feet long and, you know, several inches wide. So if you think about it, when you're in a car four-wheeling, like a truck four-wheeling, it has contact patches about that wide in four different areas. So it has less contact than what this track does. And you're putting 5,000 pounds on it, as opposed to putting, you know, 250, not you, but 250 pounds on
this. You're generous, Chris.
This will stay right on top of the sand and snow. It's amazing how well it goes through sand and snow.
Yeah, even this, you know, this wide blade Bermuda or whatever this stuff is, it does do pretty well. And you gave me a pro tip when you're turning, you know, to also move it so that it kind of cuts through. And so that's kind of the key. If you had to give somebody one piece of advice, somebody looks at this video and they say, you know what, I'm a little nervous about the Freedom Tracks, but I want to get out there, I want to live life, because life is defined by experiences. What would you say to kind of gently encourage somebody to give this a try?
Well, one of the things I keep saying is that, you know, weevils wobble and they don't fall down, and there's a reason for that. It's because everything's weighted at the bottom. You've got 75 pounds here that are real low. So it would be very hard for you to tip over. I mean, you've got to work to do it. So, and then you've got the wheels front back, which is going to catch you.
And so if somebody sees this video and they want to give this a shot, how do they get a hold of you, Chris?
Freedom Tracks International, either the website or Facebook page. We do a lot on Facebook.
Okay.
We also have Freedom Tracks, which is our R&D, and that's the national part. And Freedom Tracks Cozumel, which is our rental in Cozumel, Mexico.
Freedom Tracks Cozumel. Okay, so you're already deploying this thing internationally. And before we go, one last thing, Chris. Describe the Freedom Tracks in one word or phrase for me.
It's a dream. Basically, that's what Gabby said, is I can go to all the beautiful places in Cozumel that I couldn't go before.
Yeah, he can. Gabby can go to the beautiful places in Cozumel he hasn't gone before. I can take my life into my hands at a tennis court. Either way, you're going to be able to do what you want to do in the Freedom Tracks.
There
this is
go.
Brett with my new friend Chris. As always, keep rolling.